What is up guys, कैसे हो आप लोग? In the last 2-3 months, the Honda Trans Alp and the Suzuki V-Strom 800DE came to the Indian market at a very competitive price point. And today in this video, I'll be riding the 800DE from Suzuki. So today with us, we have Puneet who has recently bought his Suzuki V-Strom 800DE. How much time it has been, Puneet?
It's been 1.5 months so far. Traveled around 1300-1400 kilometers on that.
So you have a fair idea of the bike in terms of how it's performing, right?
Yeah, I'd say that.
And you have done the first service as well, right?
Yes,
the checkup first service, right?
Yes, first service is also.
Okay, so that was run at around 1000 kilometers?
Around 800-850 kilometers.
If I ride this motorcycle right now, are there any limitations on the RPM for me?
No limitations? No.
We can just go all out on this?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So that is what we'll do. I'll swap bikes with Puneet. I'll ride the 800DE and he'll ride my Tiger 900 Rally Pro. And we are heading towards Jewar, which is around 45 kilometers from this place. So going there, coming back, we'll be riding around 100 kilometers and we'll be sharing a decent amount of feedback in terms of what this motorcycle feels like and whether if you want to buy a middleweight adventure touring motorcycle, you should consider this or, you know, look at higher priced options. So let's get on the bike and get started. So here we go. Here we have the 800DE and let's get on the bike. Yeah, all set. चलो TC is 2, what does that mean?
कौन सा?
TC traction control 2 at maximum.
रोड 1 करोगे तो सबसे मिनिमलिस्टिक है, 3 इज द
हाईएस्ट. So here we go, we are off. First time riding the 800DE Suzuki V-Strom. From any Japanese machine, you expect two things, smoothness and reliability. And I tell you, within the first 100 meters that I've ridden, I can say this feels like a super smooth machine. It doesn't even have that twin character that it should actually have. This is a twin cylinder motorcycle churning out around 80 odd Newton meters of torque and 80 bhp of power. 83 is the number, I guess. So for a twin, you expect some vibrations, a little bit of that vibey, raspy, throaty sort of an exhaust note. All those things are absolutely not there. They are completely absent on this machine. We are riding on the third gear at 55 kmph, just near Parichok area, and we'll just get on the expressway, the Yamuna expressway from this place. Another thing that I'm feeling right now is that the clutch feels heavy. It feels much more heavier than my Tiger. Kind of a big surprise, the heaviness on the clutch. You see this? It has a torque. I mean, smoothness doesn't mean that this will not have the torque and the fun that you need on the machine. The torque comes in very quickly and all these Suzuki motorcycles are equipped with that low speed assist feature, which means that these motorcycles won't stall. There is that fear of stalling a motorcycle when you're riding a big ADV on off-road sections. You have to crawl sometimes going down a descent. You have to keep the perfect play between clutch and throttle. Here, the low speed assist is something that will prevent this motorcycle from stalling. We are in 4th gear, 60 kmph, 5th gear, 60 kmph, 6th gear, 60 kmph. Are there any vibes? No. Thoda sa udhar hoke video bana raha hu. Haan. We are on the expressway and let's start the ride. 6th gear, 103 kmph. I am wearing my motor goggles, so I think there will be a good amount of wind blast that you will be hearing. But trust you me guys, the smoothness is something that you will get to know only when you ride this machine. I don't know what Suzuki has done on this. The vibration dampening on the handlebar, the vibration dampening on the foot pegs is just amazing. The windscreen on this motorcycle is a joke. The manufacturers tend to loot all the owners by, you know, not giving good quality windshields that actually serve the purpose. This one is another example. See, the height is not great. It seems more like a windshield meant for off-roading. And on the highway, when I'm sitting straight, huge amount of wind blast hitting. I'm wearing the MX goggles, so as it is, I am able to feel more wind blast than you would feel on a proper helmet with a visor down. Now let's just give this V-Storm a punch, a full throttle experience from the sixth gear, and see how it goes. The torque comes in. Now, wow, lovely. Went to 160 easily. And did I feel any wipes? No, none at all. Another thing that you will feel about the whole riding geometry is that, as expected of an adventure tourer, this is very comfortable. The seat deserves a special mention here because it is wide, provides great amount of cushioning. So I can easily imagine myself spending a full 14-15 hour day on the saddle on this machine. This is like one of those no fuss machines. I had a Japanese machine before the Tiger. I used to own a Kawasaki Versys 650. That was another example of Japanese engineering. Just perfect. No frills, just pure reliability and smoothness. But the Versys was nowhere near as smooth as this Suzuki. So Suzuki definitely does some extra magic and makes their motorcycles even more smoother. We are doing 120 kmph on 6th gear, and all good? We are doing 5th gear 100 kmph, now in the 6th at 100 kmph. And one thing that is noticeable, to my surprise, is even on the highway, I can feel the warm wind coming, the warm air coming from the engine. There is some amount of heat that is hitting on the inside of my right foot. Although I'm wearing proper adventure touring pants and a full adventure touring boot as well, both of these things, the boot, the riding boot and the pant, have good heat insulation. Still, I'm able to feel the heat coming from the engine. This is a big surprise. Normally on a Japanese motorcycle, you don't expect that much of a heat. Specifically, if you're talking about a adventure touring machine, this is not that much of a high compression engine as a sports bike. So I'm surprised with this heating aspect. Is it an issue? No, not really, because I am just mentioning it because of the expectations that people have from Japanese machines. Now let's talk about this instrument cluster. In front of you is this, what is this? A 5-inch display or a 3.5-4-inch display? I think that's the size. It's very, very simple in nature. No shushan, as they call it. The display on the Tiger seems much more premium and much more good, much better in terms of quality. This does the job. The colors are good, the contrast ratios are good, readability is pretty good. So nothing in terms of functionality that is hindering the ride experience, be it this display or the motorcycle as a whole. Everything is working just fine. The throttle on this machine feels amazing. It's so smooth, man. We have this guy on his Apache on the left. He is constantly trying to match the speeds that we are doing, and he's doing it pretty well. Look at him. Look at that guy. Look at him. Why is he trying to do it? I don't know. In terms of handling, moving left to right, changing lanes, feels very easy in this machine. If I compare it to the Tiger that I ride, Tiger feels a little more top heavy than this. This one is a lot more nimbler. Now if you look at the instrument display closely here, it's showing 237 kilometers of range. From what I have understood, this bike gives a total tank range of around 400 odd kilometers, 20 liter tank, so around 20-21 kilometers of mileage. Right now it's giving an instantaneous mileage of what? It's showing 20, 30, 22, so just don't believe that. The engine is running decently cool, 84 degrees Celsius. It also shows the air temperature as 37 degrees Celsius. The traction control is set at 2, which is the max. The ABS is also in the road mode, which is at 2. SDM is A, that means it is in the maximum power mode. All the essential stuff is there on the instrument display. Now, just if you look beyond the instrument display, this whole area, this looks too simple for a 13 lakh rupee motorcycle. I mean, that's my only complaint. And that's the thing with all the Japanese products. They prefer function over form, which is great. But if you're spending 13 lakhs, then you better have both. That's my, take on expensive motorcycles. You expect everything after spending a bomb, right? If you have to still cut corners, then it doesn't actually make the cut for me. There you see my beauty, the Tiger 900 being ridden by Puneet. It's an altogether different experience when you see your bike being ridden by somebody else, right? But I was talking about the suspension. The suspension is fully adjustable. At the front, you have adjustability on the rear shock as well, like all motorcycles. So that is something that can be customized as per the rider, the pillion, the luggage you are carrying. Sixth gear. I so wish this machine had a cruise control, guys. This is capable of doing these speeds all day long and in a very, very smooth manner. That is the most important thing. I mean, Adventure 390 will do 120, 130 all day long, but will you feel anywhere as comfortable as you will feel on a proper twin cylinder adventure touring motorcycle? No. This is what this machine would do. It will give you that comfort that you need. And that's why I say, why the hell did Suzuki not provide a cruise control is beyond my imagination. 130, 140, 6th gear. It's just so cool. This goes to 155 in fact. So that's the tractability of a twin cylinder machine. Bhai ruk ja. Puneet is gone on his own ride and has just forgotten to take the left. Let's do it from here. So we have reached Jewar. This was a good around 45-50 kilometers of a ride. Truly loved it. The experience was amazing. I hope you also enjoyed the first person view of riding this brand new Suzuki V-Storm 800 DE. And we are now just heading to Starbucks to debrief on the ride because we swapped motorcycles. I ride a Tiger, he rides a V-Storm. We just swapped it and let's see what Puneet has to say about the Tiger. And I'll share my feedback about the V-Storm 800D. Let's get a Starbucks coffee.